So today we are going to continue with the conductivity series, and this is going to be a volume 8. So we are going to talk about commands, different operational command and utility command as part of this session. So we are just going to be familiarized with that, how we can utilize those commands. I'm going to choose specific 4 or 5 commands and when to use those commands basically. So first of all, first command is plan admin set parameter name and value. So I have talked about the dynamic parameters, right? So we can set the any particular parameter as a dynamic at the level of graph, plan or a task, okay? And that value of that parameter can be amended and passed over to the following task or maybe a plan, okay, plan task or a sub plan probably. So the only thing is it should be defined as a defined as a dynamic, okay. So this is that, okay. So where we can set this, what we can do is in the level of perform method, we can do in the program task, perform method, we can set this anywhere where we can, when we use the script and so that place we can execute, this command can be placed and we can assign the value of the parameter, okay. Now so the second is a plan admin and give the plan name, okay, and then I think if you want to shut down the plan, then REC shut. Okay. This is to use, the shutting down the plan. Actually, you can execute this command, while plan is running. And so mostly, whenever we execute, because at shutdown method, basically, if you want to, know the plan name and then recovery file, so at shutdown method, we can define and there we can execute this. Okay. So mostly it executes in, shutdown method. So similarly, there are, plan admin, commands basically. So similarly, we have a plan admin skip on plan restart. So what we can do is we can have a plan admin plan name, plan name dot recovery basically, and then skip on restart. What we can do is whenever we and task name, okay, task name, so we want to skip that particular task. Let's say we have task A and B and C and D, okay, and our task B has failed, and after recovery we want to skip the task C, then we can do it, okay. So similarly, the other useful command could be plan admin soft shutdown. So what happens is plan admin soft dot rec name we need to give, and then soft shutdown and task name. So why we do this soft shutdown task name? So let's say we are executing one plan and we have a calling sub plan, or maybe we are calling the continuous graph task, okay, we are calling the continuous plan, continuous graph actually from the plan. So we know that there is a different setting down method for the continuous graphs basically. So what we can do is we have any different task running in the plan, and this is a continuous task is one of it, and we know that whenever we start the continuous, we have to shut down it, right? So we need to manually shut down it. It doesn't stop without shutting down, okay? It will keep on executing, okay? So what we can do is within the plan, let's say, or other tasks are running and we want to shut down that particular task which is running the continuous graph, we can supply this command. And at plan level, other tasks, which will be keep on executing, and the only task which is going to shut down is a graph task which is continuous. And it will be a, the status of this is going to be blue, I mean the success, okay? And whenever other task is going to be successful, then the plan is going to be successful. So this is used whenever we have, continuous graph running as part of plan. So this is one use actually. Okay, so other we can, while how we use the plan admin set is there, unset is also there. We want to unset the the value of the parameter. If we want to view the job, plan admin view job, plan admin view job. So these are the different command I was talking about. Set and unset both can be done. So these are called operational commands actually. So to maintain the start or stop the process basically. So then there are utility commands basically. So the m_plan, we can create the plan using this command, and m_pool, we can create the resource pool, right? You are talking about resource management. So we can define the script and we can create the whole plan basically using these commands, okay? So complete syntax I'm not going to remember actually. I don't remember that complete syntax. So whenever so this is to make aware that we have existing scripts which are available to create the whole plan basically from the scratch using the scripts commands. And similarly, we have m_pool command which maintains and creates the existed plans and existed pool, resource pool, okay? So this is about commands actually. So to make you aware that we have a command line interface for maintaining the conductivity, okay? Thank you so much.